Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I have a super exciting video, and I know I say that at the beginning of literally every single video, but today's video is going to be a huge compilation of all of my favorite summer essentials. And what I mean by this is I literally use these products on a daily basis, and I don't think I could go a whole summer long without these products. So I am going to share all these items with you. I'm so excited because hopefully this can give you guys some ideas for some summer items. We are just going to dive right in because there's a lot of products, so we have a lot to get through. So let's just jump right into the video. All right, you guys. So I guess I'll just start with what's right in front of me, which is probably the number one summer essential, and that is sunscreen. So I have two here to show you guys. The first one is the Copper Tone sunscreen, and this is SPF 30. I use a variety of SPFs. Sometimes I use 8, 15, 30, 50, like depending on what I'm feeling that day. But I love Copper Tone because I love the smell of it. It's nostalgic to me, and I love it. It smells like summer in a bottle. And it like literally smells like the lake. It brings me back to all those memories. I use this every single year, and it just brings me right back to summertime. So this is a definite essential for me. And then when I'm not using like a regular SPF, I use the Banana Boat Deep Tanning Oil Spray Sunscreen, and this is SPF 4. Now I know some of you guys are going to come at me for using an oil because, like my mom always says, it's like you're frying your skin like you're bacon, which yeah, it's true. And I'm very fair, so I do fry very easily. But I love this stuff for my legs because my legs is the one thing on my body that does not burn that easily. Like the tops of my shoulders burn like crazy, my chest, my face. So I like to put this on my legs because this gives me additional color. And I just love the moisture and the hydration this gives me because it gives you that glow, that summer glow that we all crave and want. So definite must. Now I'm going to talk about two after sun products that I love and adore. This one I wear when I am burnt. Like I am burnt to a crisp and I need help. And this is the Hawaiian Tropic Silk Hydration After Sun Lotion. This is in the scent Coconut Papaya. I love this stuff. So I actually have a little secret that I will give you guys. I put this on when I'm like burnt to a crisp, like lobster looking. I put this on and then I put this product on, which I will mention next. And it is like the perfect duo. And I promise you, it will help your burn go away so much faster. Like there's times that I will be so burnt that I think it's gonna last at least a couple days and it will go away overnight with these two products. It smells good and it doesn't smell as good as Copper Tone and Banana Boat, but it does smell good. And it's like a gel consistency, very cooling. Like you could put this in the fridge and then when you come off the boat or back from the lake day or whatever you're doing, you could apply this and it would be so cool and it would feel so good on your skin. But I love this because it's not sticky, because I have had times in the past where I've used an aloe and I've lathered my body in it. I've put like a shirt on and I go to bed and I sleep and then I wake up the next morning and I literally have to peel the shirt off my skin because it's sticking. And I hate that because when you have a burn, stuff like that hurts like really bad. So this stuff does not do that and it does not even leave you sticky. So I could wear this even if it's not before bed, like if I'm wearing this like maybe out to dinner after we've been outside all day in the sun, and you would have no idea that I'm wearing aloe. So I love this. And then after that, I'll go in with this product. And this is the Banana Boat Moisturizing Aloe After Sun Lotion. It clearly, you can tell I used a lot of this. And clearly you can tell I use a lot of this. This is like, I've had multiple bottles of this. And I have multiple bottles of this on rotation as well. This stuff is amazing. It smells good, it's lightweight, and these two products paired together is like a dream team. I'll even just use this as my moisturizer sometimes during the summer just because I love the smell of it. And aloe is always great because it soothes your skin. And it says at the bottom, which I didn't know this, but it has pure aloe vera and vitamin E that preserves and extends your tan. That's kind of cool. But yes, I swear by this. I love this and would highly recommend this to anybody. And kind of following along on that same moisturizing train, this is what I use when I'm not using an aloe. And this is the Jergens Oil Infused Softening Vanilla for Visibly Soft Skin 24 Hour Moisturizer. The names on products nowadays are getting so long, it's like overkill. But I love this stuff. Jergens is my go-to no matter what time of year it is. In the winter time, I'll use, I think it's the argan oil lotion. I think that's it. There's also like a coconut scent. This one's vanilla. They have a bunch of different scents, but I love this stuff. This stuff makes my skin like baby soft. And a fun fact, my boyfriend, he always comments about how soft my skin is. And I honestly couldn't say like what product in particular it is, because I do use a lot of different products, but this is definitely a contributor because this stuff does make your skin super soft. It's not oily, doesn't leave like a weird residue. It's just, it's good. I don't know what else to say. So this next item is kind of a random item, but I definitely wanted to throw this in for my curvier, thicker gals. I am one of those girls, and we all know if you don't have a thigh gap, that in the summertime, chafing is so painful, and it's a real thing that a lot of us experience. Now, a lot of us like to talk about it because it's not something we want to like advertise on the billboards, but this product helps so much. Recently, I've been running, and in the humidity where I live, it's like everything gets sweaty and your sweat doesn't evaporate, and so it just sticks to your skin and doesn't help anything when you're chafing. So I put this on in between my thighs, and this is the Monistat Chafing Relief Power Gel. I ordered this off of Amazon and it was like $5. I was like, you know what, I'm gonna give it a try. It feels like, might be able to show you, there you go. You can see it's like a silicone. It reminds me of like a silicone primer, and you rub it in and it just gives you that slick surface basically. And I expected to be able to see it, and I'm like, oh my gosh, everyone's gonna know that I'm wearing this chafing cream or chafing gel. No, you cannot see this. It is completely transparent and clear, and it has saved me on all my runs that I've been going on. If you're doing hiking or you are just wearing shorts, this is gonna come in handy, and I promise you, you guys are gonna love this. If you have thicker thighs, this is gonna save you. So I now have two skincare products that I love and adore. I'm gonna start with this one, and this is the Tula sunscreen SPF 30. You guys, this stuff is so gorgeous. I can't even like explain to you how pretty that is. Well, maybe I can swatch it. I've never done a swatch before. So maybe I can try. Okay, so this stuff gives you the prettiest glow without you looking greasy. It is just, oh, there you go. You can see it. And it's not something that you just put on your face and it's glowy, it's pretty for like 5 minutes. No, this stays all day. Like, look at that. It makes your skin look so beautiful. And an added bonus is that it's an SPF. But I love this stuff because it also works super well under makeup, and that's important. You know, you don't want your makeup to crumble and fall off your face. That would not be good. So this stuff is amazing, and it's made with probiotics and superfoods, so it's super clean and it's not gonna clog your pores. But yeah, this stuff, it's amazing. I highly recommend it. And the last skincare product is the Summer Fridays CC Me Serum. And this is a vitamin C serum. Now, I did not realize how much I needed this in my life until I had it and I was using it. I use this every morning, and I do it at night, not often. It's mostly in the morning, but it's helped with my pigmentation of my freckles. Now, I love and adore my freckles, and I would never try to cover that up, but they can be super dark and super prominent. Some are really big, like I have a really big one on my nose, and this just kind of helps tame the darkness. Like, I still have a lot of freckles, but this just kind of helps them not be so dark and so prominent, especially because I am such a fair complexion that when my freckles come out, it is like bam, like you can see every single one of them. So I've really enjoyed this serum for that reason, but I also just love it because it brightens my complexion and it's just lovely to use. But yeah, I love this vitamin C serum. It's wonderful, it's gorgeous. 10 out of 10. Next, we're gonna jump into fragrance. I don't wear a fragrance every day, if I'm being honest, but some days I do like to have a little bit of a fragrance or a little bit of a mist just to kind of freshen things up a little bit. So these are some of my favorites. This is the Ralph by Ralph Lauren perfume. This stuff is amazing. This is one of those things I've been using since high school. It smells so good. I'm not gonna be good at describing scents, so I apologize, but this just smells so clean, but not like a laundry clean. It's not really florally. Okay, I can't pinpoint it, so let me grab my phone and look up how Sephora would describe this scent, because I am not gonna do this justice. Okay, so the description is exactly the opposite of what I was saying. It says, this floral fragrance is for women who dare to live in vivid color. Sparkling green apple, zesty Mediterranean tangerine, and magnetic pink magnolia give way to seductive purple freesia. I think that's how you say it, freesia? And soft blue musk. So it is a floral fragrance. I wouldn't classify it as that. I guess that's not what I smell off right off the bat, because when I think of a floral fragrance, I think of like an overabundance of flowers, which that's not at all what I smell. But nevertheless, I love this. This is probably my second bottle at least of this. This is one of those fragrances that, at least for me, it stays on for a very long time. So love this stuff. Now, on the days that I don't want a fragrance that's that powerful and it's gonna last a super long time, I opt for these bad boys. And I am bringing you back to your middle school days or your high school days, where Victoria's Secret body mists were the thing. Like, everybody loved them, everybody had them. And I happened to be in store before this whole COVID-19 happened, and I saw these on the shelf, and I just happened to smell them, and I'm like, okay, like, I need these in my life because these smell amazing. So this first one is Saint Tropez Beach Orchid. Smells so good. This is more of like a warmer scent. And then the other one that I picked up was the Bali Coconut Palm, and this is coconut nectar and fresh pineapple. And this, I just tend to gravitate towards coconut scents in the summer, just because when I think of like a summer fragrance, I automatically think of coconut. It's just the first thing that comes to mind. It smells amazing. I love it. It's perfect. And I could literally douse myself in this and it's never going to be too strong. And at least they have more like grown-up packaging now, so I don't feel like I'm a teenager again using body mists. But hey, you know, summertime calls for a lighter fragrance, and these bad boys definitely give me that vibe. Next is another essential for summertime, and that is sunglasses. So I have a couple pairs here. I could honestly do a whole video on my sunglass collection, because I collect sunglasses like no other. They're like my favorite accessory, because you can really play down a look, make it look more sporty, make it look more chic. You can literally do so much with sunglasses, but I picked two pairs that I wear and I grab four the most often. And these are gonna be so dirty, so I apologize. So this first pair is by the brand Key, and I love these so much. They're just your typical black aviator. Of course they're crooked, but I love these. They are so perfect. They actually are like black. Like, you can't see my eyes through them, which is huge for me. I don't want to be able to see my eyes. I want to be like blacked out. But I definitely gravitate towards this pair when I'm feeling more like a sporty look. But I definitely love these. And then my other more chic pair, I guess, if you will. These are actually Airy sunglasses. And I think it's the Let the Real You Shine sunglasses. They might have updated their name, because I know I've seen these on their website. So I'll try and link them below. But I love these. These are the tortoise ones. Holy cow, these are so dirty. I have my niece's fingerprints like right here, so I'm scared to get close to the camera. These are the other pair. I love these. I have these in black as well. And they're perfect. They give a more chic vibe, or if you are wearing a like nicer outfit, these will definitely go with your outfit. But yeah, I love them. And it would not be a summer essentials video without a bathing suit. Like, let's be honest. So I have one bathing suit here just merely to show you, but I buy all my bathing suits, or the majority of my bathing suits, from this brand, and it's Airy. Airy has the best swimsuits. They're accommodating for like all body sizes, and I just love them. They're so comfortable and it's just, you can't beat them. And especially for the price, they're always on sale. So I placed a rather large order at the beginning of this year because I was going on a cruise in the Caribbean, which didn't end up happening, but I bought all these bathing suits for that. But this one in particular, I love the style of, but it looks like this. It's just like a scoop neck bathing suit. And this is the back. And then here are the bottoms. Just looks like this. And the back, it's kind of cheeky, but not super cheeky. So you could definitely wear this if you're like going to a pool party with like family. Like this is definitely appropriate. If I can find the names of these, I will link them down below. But they come in so many different colors. I just love this bathing suit. It's so comfortable. It's flattering. It's easy. Yeah. There's that. Another accessory that I absolutely love for summer is a sun hat. Now, I am trying to protect the skin that I'm in. So I bought this sun hat off of Amazon and it's literally perfection. It like rolls up like this and then you can put this little twisty tie around it. And so you can travel with it and it's not gonna like bend out of shape. It has a hole in the top. So you could literally wear your hair in a ponytail or a bun or however you wanna wear it and it's not gonna ruin your hair. This is seriously the cutest thing I think I've ever seen. You can like finagle this front piece. It's kinda got like a wire in it to like fit however you want to, but it is just so cute. It's not overly big where you feel like a prima donna on the beach, but it's like the perfect width, I guess. And it's just so perfect for reading at the beach and you can kind of block the sun from the top. I love this and I don't know how I lived my life without this beforehand, honestly, because it's amazing. And another fabulous thing about this is that it also comes with a strap that you can put around your chin to help so it won't fly off. But this is definitely a favorite of mine. Okay, so now on to some fashion items. I'm gonna start with shoes because these shoes I could not go a summer without. And if you haven't guessed by now, or if you know me, you probably have guessed, and those shoes are Birkenstocks. And I swear are the best summer shoe. Like, I will never go a season without these. I've actually had these for, I want to say, at least 5 years. And this was like my original pair that I ever bought. You can tell how much I've used them because you can see my toe imprints on them. They say not to wear these in the water, but I have been at the beach. My foot's been wet. I've slipped them in and it's been fine. I've even dropped these in the lake and they're still fine. The cork is starting to bust on the sides here, but that's just due to wear and tear. And probably water, to be honest with you. But these are a definite essential. But if you don't want to bust out all your pennies for this pair, I also have found a dupe. Not for this particular style, but if you know Birkenstocks, then you know that they have the two-strap option or the two-strap style. And I found these off of Amazon, and I kid you not, these look like real Birkenstocks. I've had people stop me and ask me, like, are those Birks? And I'm like, no, they're not. They're actually like a fraction of the price. And these are them. They are white and dirty, and I apologize. I love these. These are fabulous. Since I already have a white pair, I was like, I don't really need another white pair, an actual, you know, because this is like a pearly white, because I wanted like a white. High maintenance, I know, but I wanted like a plain white pair. And so I ordered these off of Amazon and absolutely fell in love with them. Then I ordered a black pair as well, just because I wasn't sure how much I'd wear white and black. So I wanted to try these out and give these a fair shot, because I'd rather spend a quarter of the price than spend, you know, a ton of money on these, even though they're worth it. Highly, highly worth it. Sometimes you just need a pair that's not gonna break the bank. So these are it, and these are literally perfection. They feel just as soft and comfortable and squishy and perfect, and they are even starting to mold to my foot, which is what Birkenstocks do. So if you're looking for a cheaper alternative to Birkenstocks, these are it, my friend. Like, they are wonderful and I'd highly recommend them. All right, the last fashion item that I have is shorts, because you can't go a summer without shorts, like, let's be honest. So I have three pairs of shorts to show you, two athletic pairs and then a denim pair. So I'll start with the denim, and I will try and try on some of this stuff for you so you can actually see like what they look like on. So I will insert them as we go. These are the Goldie, I think these are the Parker vintage shorts. I will put everything in the description box below, the exact items, if I can find them and if they're in stock. But they look like this. Love these bad boys. They're like the perfect wash. They're not like a dark wash, but they're not a light wash. And like there are some rips in them, but it's very minimal. Like there's not a whole ton, but they look like this. And here's the back. They are a very true denim. Like there's no stretch to these, but I did stick to my true size and they fit perfect. One thing I will say with these is that they do stretch out, so just fair warning, but I do like that look because it kind of gives it a lived in look. But I did stick with my true size, and although they are a little bit big in the waist, the thighs fit perfectly, like the butt in the thigh area fits perfectly. But I find that to be true with a lot of my jeans and shorts and any denim really, is that the waist is always bigger because I need more room in the butt and the thigh region because I am a curvy gal. But nonetheless, I love this pair. Yes, they're pricey, but this is a pair of shorts that I will have for years to come. I already know it. So I love these and I will link them down below. All right, so my first pair of athletic shorts are these, and these are the Lululemon Runtime shorts, and they look like this. It's just a plain black pair, and the back has a zipper up top, and I currently have the waist like completely drawn in because, like I said before, my waist is much smaller than my hips, so I have to do that with anything basically. But I absolutely love these. I wear these running. They are the most comfiest athleisure lounge short ever. Well, okay, yeah, this would be the number one. The next short I'm going to show you, which is like half the price if not more, those are also perfect, so that would be my number two. But I love these. I would recommend these to anybody, but I have a feeling they're discontinuing these. So I actually found an alternative that are basically the same short. So I don't know if they're like just renaming it, but they're called the Speed Up shorts. I don't have one with me right now. It's actually in my closet, but those are very similar to these. So I will link both pairs down below, but they're perfect. They're stretchy. They do have a built-in underwear, but one thing that I love about these shorts is the waistband. It's like a soft but thick material versus like the short part, and it just makes it super comfortable when it sits around your waist. Like it doesn't dig in or, you know, make you uncomfortable in any way. So highly recommend these. But if you're looking for a cheaper option, these are it. They look like these they look like this. And I just discovered these recently, and they are DSG, and I believe that stands for Dick's Sporting Goods, because I did indeed buy these off of Dick's, so I'm pretty sure that's what it stands for. But it's the DSG shorts, and I will link them down below. These, my friend, are amazing. They have a very comfortable waistband. They're very comfortable. They're like relaxed in the legs. Same as a Lululemon pair. It doesn't like hug your thighs. Well, but these are amazing. I love them, and I love them so much that this is embarrassing, but I bought them in four other colors. So if that doesn't tell you how much I love these, I don't know what will. They're just so perfect. They're stretchy, like they're a stretchy material. Perfect athleisure wear, lounge wear, running, any sort of sport that you do, they're gonna stay up. They're just amazing. Whew. Two more products. Can you hang in there? I'm dying, like my throat is so dry. But this is actually my second to last favorite, and I mentioned this in my very first video. It was my March favorites video, and these are the Yeti cups. They're bougie, they're expensive, but I promise you they are 110% worth it. These things keep ice like no other cup I've ever had. Perfect for lake days, boat days, and perfect for those of you that need ice cold water 24/7, which is me. I cannot drink warm or lukewarm water like at all. Like I will not. So I love these, and I will forever and always have one of these. I got my boyfriend into them. This is kind of funny, but my family used to be totally against these because they're like, that's so expensive. That's so much money to spend on one single cup. Well, guess who has them? My mom, my dad, my boyfriend's parents have them. They love them. It's like, there's just no denying that they're just the best. So if you like your water cold 24/7, get these. Finally, my last favorite. I saved the most expensive item for last, so I'm very, very, very sorry. But I recently took a poll on my Instagram asking if I should buy this, and honestly, it was like 50-50. But I ended up doing it anyways. But shout out to my mom because she bought this for me, and I will forever love you for it. Thanks, Mom. But it is, that's so big. It is a Yeti cooler, and I believe this is, oh no, I forgot the name of it. I think it's the Hopper 35, hold on. Okay, so this bad boy is the Hopper M30 Soft Cooler. And I got it in the charcoal color, and it looks like this. I'll try to fit the whole thing in the camera. I will insert a picture so you guys can actually see it. But this is so good, you guys. Like, if you have a boat or you do a lot of like outdoor activities where you pack lunches or you're gone all day, this is so nice and so handy to have. Yeah, the price tag sucks, not gonna lie, but it is worth it. Like I said, with my water bottle, it just keeps all of your items so cold, and it's so handy because of the fact that there's this long strap that you can put around you and have it over the shoulder, and it has this magnetic closure. So they used to have a zipper that had like really like tough little, what do you call those things, like little grooves, little, I don't know, teeth that would actually like hurt people's arms as you would like dig down into your cooler. So they changed it to this magnetic strip, and it is like powerful, you guys. Like, look, like it's powerful. So I have been using this a lot, almost every time we go on the boat. Well, every time we go on the boat now, we take this, and my mom loved it so much she bought herself one. So coming from the gal that never bought Yeti stuff because it was expensive. So I love this thing, and I'm so glad I got it. It is just, it makes life easy because it functions as a cooler. It functions as a towel bag, or if you have wet bathing suits, it doubles as a beach bag and a cooler. And bonus that we just found out, it floats. So just the other weekend, my boyfriend and I were walking from the beach to the boat, and we were, had to go through the water, or he was holding it up and like going through, and he got tired and he set it down in the water, and it actually floated. So that's pretty impressive. Just an added little bonus, but I love it. It's amazing. There's not much more to say. All right, you guys, I think that was enough items. I don't even know how many items that was, but it was a lot. But I love all these products so much, and yeah, I'm happy I got to share them with you. I will leave all of these items that I've mentioned in this video, I'll link them down below in the order that you see them. And make sure to give this video a thumbs up if you like it. And if you want to continue to see more videos, please subscribe and stick around. And I can't wait to see you in the next video. Bye.